Chapter 5, Morphology of Flowering Plants, Question Answers from Class 11, Subject Biology. Exercises. Question 1. How is pinnately compound leaf different from a palmately compound leaf? Answer. In a pinnately compound leaf, the lamina is divided into a number of leaflets that are arranged along a central axis called the rachis, which is the continuation of the petiole. Example, neem, azadirachta, indica. In a palmately compound leaf, the leaflets are attached at a common point on the tip of the petiole, like the fingers of a hand radiating from the palm. Example, silk cotton, bombax, ceiba. Second, explain with suitable examples the different types of phyllotaxy. Answer, phyllotaxy refers to the arrangement of leaves on a stem or branch. There are three main types. First, alternate phyllotaxy. A single leaf arises at each node and they alternate on opposite sides. Example, sunflower, mustard, China rose. Second, opposite phyllotaxy. A pair of leaves arises at each node and lies opposite to each other. Example, guava, calotropis. Third, halt phyllotaxy. More than two leaves arise from a single node and form a circle or hall. Example, Alstonia. Question 3. Define the following terms. A. Aestivation. Answer. The mode of arrangement of sepals or petals in a floral bud with respect to the other members of the same hall. Types. Velvet. Example, Calotropis. Twisted. Example, China rose. Imbricate, example, gulmohar. Vexillary, example, pea. B. Placentation. Answer, the arrangement of ovules within the ovary. Types, marginal, axile, parietal, basal, free central. C. Actinomorphic. Answer, a flower that can be divided into two equal halves by any radial plane passing through the center. Example, mustard, datura. D. Zygomorphic. Answer, a flower that can be divided into two equal halves in only one vertical plane. Example, pea, bean. E. Superior ovary. Answer, when the gynoecium ovary is at the highest position and all other floral parts are attached below it. Example, mustard, brinjal. F. Perigynous flower. Answer, a flower in which the gynoecium is situated at the center and other floral parts are located at the rim of the thalamus at the same level. Example, rose, peach. G. Epipetalous stamen. Answer, when stamens are attached to the petals, not directly to the thalamus. Example, brinjal, tomato. Question 4. Differentiate between A. Racemose and cymose inflorescence. Feature, growth of main axis. Racemose inflorescence continues to grow indefinitely. Cymose inflorescence terminates in a flower. Next, order of flower opening. Racemose inflorescence, acropetal, older flowers at base, younger at top. Cymose inflorescence, basipetal, younger flowers at base, older at top. Example, racemose inflorescence, reddish, mustard. Cymose inflorescence, jasmine, ixora. B. Apocarpus and syncarpus ovary. Feature, number of carpels. Apocarpus ovary more than one. Syncarpus ovary more than one. Fusion, apocarpus ovary, carpels are free. Syncarpus ovary, carpels are fused. Apocarpus ovary, example, lotus, rose. Syncarpus ovary, example, tomato, mustard. Question 5. Draw the labeled diagrams of the following. First, gram seed, dicot seed. So friends, this is the diagram. Next, VS of maize seed. So friends, this is the diagram. Question 6. Take one flower of the family Solanaceae and write its semi-technical description. Also draw their floral diagram. Answer. Semi-technical description of a flower from Solanaceae family. Example, brinjal. Habit, herb, inflorescence, solitary and axially or cymose, flower complete, bisexual, actinomorphic, calyx, sepals 5, united, green, persistent, velvet aestivation, corolla, petals 5, united, funnel-shaped, velvet aestivation, androecium, stamens 5, epipetalous, free, attached to corolla, gynoecium, bicarpellary, syncarpus, superior ovary, bilocular, axile placentation. Fruit, berry, seed, many, endospermic, floral formula. So friends, this is the floral formula and this is the floral diagram. 5 united sepals, 5 united petals, 5 stamens attached to corolla, a bilocular ovary. Question 7. Describe the various types of placentation found in flowering plants. Answer. Placentation refers to the arrangement of ovules inside the ovary. First, marginal, ovules on one side along margin, unilocular ovary, example P. Second, axile, ovules attached to central axis in multilocular ovary, example tomato, lemon. Third, parietal, ovules on ovary wall or periphery, unilocular but appears bilocular, example mustard, argemon. Fourth, free central, ovules on a central axis with no septa, example primrose. Fifth, basal, ovule at the base of the ovary, example sunflower, marigold. Question 8. What is a flower? Describe the parts of a typical angiosperm flower. Answer. A flower is a modified shoot of a plant that performs the function of sexual reproduction. Parts of a typical flower. A. Calyx. Outermost hull, green, leaf-like sepals, protects the bud. B. Corolla, made of petals, usually colored and scented, attracts pollinators. C. Androecium, male part consists of stamens, filament plus anther, produces pollen grains. D. Gynoecium, female part consists of carpels, stigma plus style plus ovary, contains ovules inside ovary. These parts may be arranged differently based on symmetry, position and fusion. Question 9. Define the term inflorescence. Explain the basis for the different types of inflorescence in flowering plants. Answer. Inflorescence is the arrangement of flowers on a floral axis or branch. Two main types. A. Racemose inflorescence. Main axis grows continuously. Flowers are arranged in acropetal succession, youngest at top, example reddish, mustard. B. Cymose inflorescence, main axis ends in a flower. Flowers are in basipetal succession, youngest at base, example jasmine, hibiscus. Basis, whether the growth of the floral axis is limited or unlimited. Question 10. Describe the arrangement of floral members in relation to their insertion on thalamus. Answer. Based on the position of ovary relative to other floral halls, A. Hypogynous flower, gynoecium is at the top, other halls, calyx, corolla, androecium are below it, ovary is superior, example mustard, brinjal. B. Perigynous flower, gynoecium is in the center, other floral parts on the rim at same level, ovary is half interior, example rose, peach. C. Epigynous flower, gynoecium is below, other floral halls arise above the ovary, ovary is inferior. Example, guava, cucumber. So friends, we have completed all these question answers from chapter 5, Morphology of Flowering Plants. We have already studied the short notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel. You can support me with channel membership and super thanks. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.